Welcome back, everyone. iOS 15 has officially came out in a beta form, so let's go and kind of walk through this beginner's guide on exactly how to use iOS 15. Now, first of all, booting up your specific device, you will see your lock screen, as most of you will. Now, on the bottom, you will have a couple of different options. You'll have your camera option right here, and you'll have your flashlight option right here. If you want to get into the camera, you can easily either click that button, or you can always swipe to the side, access the camera. If you want to turn on the flashlight, you can just force press here or hold it down. Both will end up working. Now, you can always scroll down to get into spotlight search if your iPhone supports it, and you can always grab from the top right to get into your control center. So those are basically the main things on the front panel. You can always get into your actual home display and all those things by either clicking the home button or by swiping to open. Now, if you have an iPhone that has Face ID, you may have to type in your passcode and all those things, but these are general things that I'm pretty sure everyone knows how to do on your iPhone. Now, front panel wise, this is where things are a little bit different. You will see that you'll have a ton of different apps. You'll see you have a ton of different widgets. And typically on the bottom, this is your dock. And this will always be here. Whether you have iOS 15, 14, 13, whatever, your dock is always going to be at the bottom. You'll always have your apps and everything here. Now, sometimes you will see that your apps may be not all there. Maybe you downloaded an app and you can't find it anymore. If you swipe all the way to the side, you'll get into your app library. This will essentially showcase to you all your apps that you have broken down in different categories. Now, on top of this, if you swipe down, you will see all of your apps right here. Now, if you're a beginner user of iOS or iPhones in general, even on iOS 15, and this is going to be a place you're probably going to spend a lot of time at while you get used to all these other, you know, things on your device, you will see all your apps here. Now, if you want an app that you want to bring back to your home screen, you can always hold it down just like this. You can always drag it out and place it to whichever display that you want. So let's say you want to go ahead and place this specific app right here. Well, you can go and place it there, and there's a lot of glitches in iOS 15 right now, they'll get better over time, but that's essentially how you go ahead and bring an app to your display. And like I mentioned, a lot of bugs, but these will be fixed by the time the official version comes out. Now, if you want to drag a widget onto your display, it's essentially the same thing, and iOS 15 makes it very easy for us to go ahead and put widgets everywhere and all that stuff. So what you want to do is swipe to the left, and you will get into this specific panel. Now, it'll go ahead and showcase to you all the widgets that you have at the time that you can go ahead and paste on your display. So you can go ahead and grab something like this and bring it over to your front display and drop it wherever you want to. Now, let's say you don't want to drop it here. Well, all you have to do is hold it down just like how I did. Just hold it down like this and essentially just drag it to another display. It's literally just like dragging something over to, like if you want to drag something from something else, the same exact process. You can always delete the widget by clicking on the minus button, clicking remove, and essentially going on from there. So that's basically a main setup of the main display. Nothing super crazy here. It's pretty much the same thing as iOS 14. However, there are some things in the Settings app that I do want to showcase to you guys before we get into a lot of the iOS 15 core features. So the Settings app looks like this. You just want to go ahead and click on it, and you'll essentially come into this type of panel. Now, this will go ahead and showcase to you all your iCloud settings. Your network connections are here. Notification and sound settings are here. One of the main areas you're probably going to end up focusing in at, though, is the general setting. So if you click on general and you click on software update, this is the area where you're probably going to spend a lot of time at. This is how you're going to update your device. So if you want to update your iPhone and you're on iOS 15, you want to go ahead and go into settings. You want to go into general, which is right here. You want to click on software update, and you want to update your iPhone if there's an update available here. This is essentially the easiest way thing to do, in my opinion, and this is probably the area you're going to spend a lot of time at. Now, if you want to go back, you can swipe like this, or you can click back like that. Both will end up working. Now, what we want to do is enable dark mode on iOS 15. So what we want to do is we want to make our way over to our settings app. So we want to click on settings. We want to scroll down until we find display and brightness. So what we want to do is we want to click on display and brightness. And all we really have to do is go and click on this little dark mode option right there. And now we will have dark mode on iOS 15. Now, let's see, you want to go back on light mode. Well, you do the same thing, but reverse. You just click on light mode, and you can see that we now have the light mode option on our specific device. So dark mode and light mode are both awesome. You have the capability of turning on both or turning off both, whichever one you actually prefer. Now, those are the main updates on this end. Now, iOS 15 brought a lot of cool features with FaceTime. So if we go down into FaceTime right here, all we want to do is make sure that FaceTime right here is enabled, and you can actually go ahead and see a couple of different options down here. Now, FaceTime, if you guys don't know, it's an app that essentially looks like this and allows you to call different people who also have iPhones. But now within FaceTime, we can actually FaceTime people who don't have iPhones, things like Android machines. or other iOS machines or whatever the case is, Windows, all these things will work. So what we want to do is you want to click on the FaceTime app just like this. You'll come into a panel that looks essentially something like this. Now, if you want to go ahead and call somebody, you can always go ahead and click New FaceTime and bring in contacts to call by typing in their name and then going and clicking FaceTime. But in this case, we have the Create Link option. So if we want to go ahead and FaceTime somebody else outside of Android, outside of iPhone, something like an Android device or something, we can go ahead and click on Create Link, and we can go ahead and copy this link and share it to somebody else. So let's go and copy that link. Let's go into our iMessage. Let's go and create a new iMessage. Let's send it to somebody who doesn't really matter. But let's go ahead and click Paste, and you will see that we now have this link right here that we can go ahead and send to people if we want them to join our FaceTime call. So before, we actually had to make sure everyone had an Android and all that stuff, but now we can actually do this without having an iPhone device. So that's another massive update, and that's essentially how you can go ahead and FaceTime people outside of, an iOS device. Now, FaceTime got a lot of cool things as well. Spatial audio, so it focuses on your voice, and grid mode on FaceTime, and things like portrait mode and share screen ability are now there on iOS 15, which is really, really awesome. Now, swiping up, as most of you know, click the home button or whatever. Now, as you can see, we have all these displays and all these things right here, which is always good to see. But another really cool thing within iOS 15 that wasn't there before is drag and drop. Now, this may be a little complex for some people, but I'll go ahead and showcase it to you because you may actually want to be able to do this on your specific device. So what we want to do is make our way over to any app that supports drag and drop. Now, it's system-wide, but in this specific case, we'll make our way over to our designated internet browser, which is the Safari browser. So let's go ahead and click here. Now, I did go ahead and automatically go to this specific webpage, but for this example, we're just going to go ahead and make our way over to apple.com. So let's just go to apple.com by typing up there. We can go and click there. And quickly, I just want to hit your Safari browser has changed a little bit on iOS 15. So the search bar is now at the bottom. Before, it used to be at the top. So now we are at the bottom. So if you ever want to type in a web page, you want to go and click here, and you'll basically be able to type in the web page here. But let's say you don't want to do that. Well, essentially, you don't really have a choice here. If you want to create a new tab, all you have to do is swipe to the side. You want to grab this search bar like this, and you want to swipe to the side. So let's go and try it. Swipe to the side, and you just created a new tab. So again, you can do the same thing. You can type in, whatever you want to. If you want to go back to the previous tab, you can go ahead and swipe here, and it will go ahead and allow you to go into the previous tab. So in this specific case, let's just scroll down on the Apple website and find an image. So in this specific case, we see this iOS 15 image right here. Well, all we need to do is go ahead and just grab an image like this, or anything for that matter. We'll get into this panel, and if I let go, you'll see that image is still there, and it essentially allows me to add photos, I can copy the image, whatever. But because we want to drag and drop, all we really need to do is go ahead and grab this thing right here, and we can go ahead and kind of swing it around everywhere. Now, at the same time, if you have a home button, you can click the home button. If you have a gesture-based iPhone, you can swipe up, and you can see I still have this image right here. Now, I can go ahead and go into any other app and go ahead and drag and drop it, and you can see I just dragged and dropped it in here, and I technically have this image saved right there, which is so cool. Now, I don't know if everyone's going to use this, but drag and drop is a really cool feature. Now, let's make our way back to our Safari browser. And like I mentioned, everything else is roughly around the same. We now have Safari extensions and everything, but this is some really cool stuff. I love being able to go ahead and have an updated browser, and you now have that capability with iOS 15. Now, I will go ahead and showcase to you exactly how to screenshot as well on iOS 15, because it's essentially the same thing. Some of you may want to know this. So in order to screenshot on this new specific software, you have a couple different options. First of all, you can always go ahead and hold the side button and the volume up button if you have an iPhone that supports the notch. So if you have an iPhone that has a notch like Face ID, then you want to go ahead and use that method. Now, if you have an iPhone like an iPhone 7 right here, what you want to do is you want to hold the power button and the home button at the same time, and that will go ahead and do a screenshot for you. So there's two different ways to do it. The same way from iOS 14, 13, 12, it's the same exact way. But like I mentioned, you do have the back tab capability that if you want to go ahead and screenshot, you have that capability too, but that's a little bit more complex, a little bit more than this beginner's guide. Now, the next thing I want to show you is screen recording. So this is another massive thing that I'm sure a lot of people want to do on their iPhone, especially on iOS 15. So what you want to do is you want to swipe to the side on your specific iPhone, and you'll see right here, you'll see this little settings icon. You want to click on settings. You want to make sure you're on this specific page, and you want to scroll down until you see Control Center. So go ahead and click on Control Center right there. And all you want to do is make sure you just want to scroll down until you see screen recording. So there's a little screen recording toggle right here. You want to make sure that the plus button is enabled right next to your screen recording option. And you want to swipe up, and as long as you see screen recording right here, you are set. So what you want to do is you want to go ahead and swipe up. You want to go up right here, and you want to go ahead and swipe down from the right side of your specific screen, and you will see this new little recording option right here. So what you want to do is you want to click on the little screen recording option right there, and it's going to count down from 3. And as soon as this is red, and if you see the little left thing that's red right there, that means your screen is being recorded. So you can go ahead and move around, you can do whatever you want to, but as soon as you're ready and you're done wanting to, you know, record the screen, you want to click on the top right corner or top left corner, and you want to click stop, and you will see that the screen recording would have stopped. In order to access the screen recording, you want to click on the Photos app right here, and you want to find the most recent specific image that you just took or the specific video, and you will see that is essentially a screen recording of everything you just did. So that's really it. That's how you screen record, a very basic process. I'm sure a majority of you know how to do this now, but this is something that's really cool and I'm really, really happy about. Now, I do want to break down another really awesome feature in this software. Now, that's essentially the main walkthrough in a beginner's guide of iOS 15. I showcased to you how to maneuver through the software, how to update your iPhone, the new updates, a couple of them. And essentially, you know, if you're a beginner of iOS 15, these are the main things that you can do on your device in order to actually, you know, take a majority of the use out of the specific software. There's a ton of features within iOS 15. I would highly recommend you not to install the software yet until it's officially come out. But as of right now, that's pretty much it. If you guys have any other questions or anything, let me know in the comment section below. Hit the like button, that'll mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it means so much if you guys get hit that. More importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.